Hello and welcome again to Stocks Advisors channel. Today we will talk about two stocks. One is Xilinx, traded at Nasdaq, ticker name XLNX, and second one is actually stock HP, Helmerich and Payne Incorporated, traded at New York Stock Exchange. And we will start with Xilinx XLNX. We see today it finished with white candles with some small upwards and downward shadows. So overall, it's very interesting action because looks like the previous wave is about to finish that started somewhere by end of November. We see it's now going down and moving average 20. The blue, the green line here is just about to catch up with the price action. So this means that we should have some move either upwards or downwards. Usually this is a very strong indication of decisive action. And to understand this, let's do a quick analysis here and to see where we are going. So as always at our daily chart, it's already finished form curve chart and candles, meaning that we are speaking of after hours, after trading session. Here we have three moving averages depicted always. It's moving average 20, 50 and 200 being green, blue and red line correspondingly. Here on the left you see their legends and here you see them being drawn. So what can we already say here from, let's start from the top of the charts, from RSI. So if you look at RSI, we see that the current wave was ongoing at the maximum, somewhere at around 150. We saw going overbought RSI wise. Now we're making this small deep dive in, meaning that we are ready if needed to return back to overbought area. Not given we do immediately, but it means there's opportunities open for us. And because the current wave is about to finish, we might start or starting a new wave. This still could take several days. We could be volatiling this area, could be volatiling horizontally, or could be a little bit declining as well, or going higher, following moving average 20, as we saw, for example, in the previous wave. When the wave was finished, we were volatiling a little bit higher before starting the next one. So all these actions are possible, but we will be preparing for some action. Also, what is interesting to see here, that the current upward trend is almost following moving average 20, so they are actually like going straight, and in that sense this trend T1 is actually very nice. It's straight, it was confirmed many times, it's showing higher heights for every next wave, and in that sense it's interesting. A little bit we need to keep in mind here that the last wave is actually it took a little bit more time to flatten out. So it might be a bit stronger resist level at 150 here to pierce further, but we will see. Anyway, moving averages are still heading up. Momentarily moving average 50 here is actually accelerative. Its second derivative is higher than zero. Moving average 200 is showing similar pattern overall going up with acceleration. The same is true for moving average 20, although it's less accelerative at the moment. Also, of course, it can be seen from the candle itself and the amount of volume traded. It's just at kind of a standard level, so we don't see any decisive action here, but it could be very interesting to enter. So with this being said, we see actually that the current price action is also being followed with a higher channel, slightly narrowing R1, and actually trading between R1 T1 is going quite stable here. So, and there is no indication further if any negative catalyst comes that we should break this situation. Also, if you look MACD wise, we are now slightly in the negative zone, meaning that we can just touch it and again start a positive wave as we saw it many times previously. You can see here, and this can be repeating again. Should we start really negative, meaning that we go for some pullback here and correction? Well, we will now discuss how to be prepared for this in case this is taking place. So, what would be the action here? First of all, it's entry at the current level already because it's the level where we are touching moving average 20, and it's quite stable to enter, quite safe. So either we will be pulled up further with the price action overall all the way until we reach again R1 channel, and then it will be fair, nice play. If we go suddenly for correction move, we pierce moving average 20 at this level, then of course the best preparation would be to take a next support line as average down, and that line would be 130, although there is higher support level. But the reason we choose 130 is also because if the price goes declining, most probably it will be stopped by moving average 50 here or in the vicinity of it, which will catch up by that time somewhere in these levels. So it will be are close to support line of 130. So if we call this line S1, it would be another level to average down. So in the vicinity of S1, we can do another buy. And again, if it will be some very strong catalyst or whatsoever, if the price really declines further, which is not given, but then if it happens, we need to be prepared for some serious decline, then it would be advised actually to enter somewhere really lower, like 115. Not at all we go those levels, but just as always, it's better to be prepared. And then it will be this level, actually also traded before as a support line here between about 115 and just higher than 110. Very rare possibility, but again, as always, we discuss all possibilities here. That would be the final average now. And now with this situation described, it will be advised to buy with 1-1-2 approach, meaning that the funds you would like to play here, you split on 4, then you buy with 1 already in the current area. If price declines, you buy with another portion. And again, just a doomsday security. If something bad happens, and this should be really some news and catalyst, in news, then if we go here, we average down again with 2 and we will be quite safe. So according to the analysis given here with this free entry point, then it would be the best optimization exchange for profit versus losses here, that you can quite safely play for XLNX. Overall, the stock is quite interesting and could be very profitable. So as always, we advise if you enter and price goes high, so if it at the first circle just exit in the vicinity of R1 or 10% profit. If you start from the second circle, then actually in the vicinity of T1 somewhere, and again 10% profit would be the best. Of course, the third one the same 10%. The reason we always keep it as 10% cutoff, because our philosophy is it's better to make many profitable trades, and this will confirm also that your strategy is correct, rather than trying to become rich from one trade, which means you are just playing a casino on stocks, actually, instead of being a trader. And that's why we advise do this. Also view other videos where we discuss another opportunities. There is always some opportunities behind the corner. Check those videos. If you like the analysis, you can play there as well. We post many videos daily. That's why be technical, be strategic in your way of trading. And this is the way for success, rather than just trying to catch a casino kind of spike of plus 800 or 1000%, which is usually like the same chance of playing casino. So okay, this is all for XLNX. Good luck with it. Now we go for another stock of today's episode. It's Helmerich and Payne Incorporated, traded at New York Stock Exchange this time, ticker name HP. Well, HP is already in overbought area. Immediately you can notice it by RSI, but it's kind of on a lower side of it. And the pattern here, the itself is quite interesting. So the wave also started to go high at end of December, but then from the beginning of November, it really started to make this very nice stepwise move. And now we are, instead of making another spike, kind of preparing for it. So kind of going high slowly, but still preparing. And what is interesting here, this the combination of these three last candles, it's white, red, doji, big body, doji, and white again. So this could be momentarily quite bullish, because also you can note here a slight acceleration of the volume. And today we saw magic cross up, but it's like, let's say, the more longer term magic cross up, because it's moving average 50 hitting from the bottom, moving average 200 here. And by the way, the same as at the previous stock, we have three moving averages here. It's 20, 50, and 200. On the left, you see depictions being green, blue, and red lines correspondingly. So coming back to the analysis, we see here that today we formed magic cross up. This caused this price to go higher, and it might be continuing. So tomorrow, although you see these volatilities, so every day almost the price action returns inside of the body of previous candle, meaning that you can already enter in this area already at 25 tomorrow, and then just go higher with this peak, because also MACD, although it's declining all the time, while this part was forming here between 23 and the current price action, but it's declining with deceleration. So it's not declining like this, it's declining like that, meaning the going down is decelerated. So it might make another either a small spike down and go high, or immediately start second wave. So with these both situations, it could be momentarily very spiky. And again, if not, if we decline, no problem, because the reason it might be also very spiky is that we crossed the previous, although being long time ago, evening star level, and this is that one, exactly coinciding actually on the bottom of the current volatility level. And this means that we are quite safe in a sense, we are going to more, let's say boost mode or about to go there. So this level S1 is quite supportive. Even if we decline downwards, at that moment here, moving average 20 will be also catching up with the price. So it would be quite nice play. And should the price decline, it will also form for us another support opportunity and average down opportunity. Because if you look carefully here, we are in volatility level before, and here is again volatility line. So it would be correct to draw it in blue in the, according to our definitions at the channel. So, and if the price will suddenly decline, that would be actually the average down area, anything below moving average 20. But then also we need to note that overall moving averages are still quite bullish here, although slightly showing the tendency to bend, especially moving average 20, but this can return again to accelerative move for it. So in that sense, it's still indecisive. Second derivatives for both moving average 20 and 50 are around zero, so it could go either way. But this momentum of today can be very promising in the short term. A longer term, again, if you don't catch it, you can just start averaging down approaches here, which is also quite safe. And then there are very well echelonated support lines. If you look here, then just trading between those should be quite safe. And should the price decline here, you can start averaging down somewhere in the middle of this channel. It would be S2, S3, and then it should be okay to do a rebounds. And again, it's advised here to buy with 1, 2, 2, meaning that money you would like to spend here, you can split in 5 portions, buy with 1, average down with 2, and second time again, average down with 2, according to these areas with, depicted with dark circles. In this sense, it should be very safe and good combination between loss and profit possibilities, because here, by that time, actually also moving average 50 will catch up with the price, and just anything below it would be very strong reversive support level. So as just depicted here, it will be in the middle of S2, S3 channel. And in that sense, this stock could be played very well. Yeah, it still has some capacity, either continue growing or just do a quick rebounce and then continue growing further. And it looks like it's about to form a, let's say, a next upwards trend here, because if you look the price action carefully, this is another possibly trend forming, let's call it T1. And as you see, anything below S1 and moving average 20 will be immediate call to reconfirm this trend. So this second entry position is very strong here and could give you good profitable play. So that's all for HP as well. These were these two stocks of today's episode. Good luck with them. And again, as we advise, don't be too greedy. Sell in time. If you have about 10% profit, there are also other opportunities behind the corner. Always at our channel, we post many videos. Just review them. Check other opportunities. Make again positive and profitable trades. So try to develop on making many positive trades rather than playing casino, trying to become rich from one trade. On this, thank you for watching. Good luck with those two stocks and see you at another episode of Stocks Advisor channel.